Hi guys, welcome to Absence Pro. Welcome to another Shopify customization video where I'm gonna show you guys how you can add percentage discount badge to your collection page and to your product page in the new Horizon theme. So recently Shopify in their summer edition have added 10 new themes where they have added a lot of features. I have created a separate video on what are the features they added. Link will be in the description. So if you don't know what is a latest themes which they created and what are the latest feature they added in the summer edition, please make sure to watch that video. In this video, I'm gonna create this badge which you can display on the collection and on the product page. This is one of the most demanding video because I have received a lot of comments on my video where it was for the Dawn theme saying that it isn't working in the Horizon theme. Definitely it's not gonna work in the Horizon theme because it was for the Dawn based theme. So all of the Dawn based theme Sense, Fresh, Color Block, it's gonna work completely fine. It's still working completely fine. But for the new Horizon base where they have added the 10 new themes with this Horizon base, you will have to implement the customization which I'm telling you in this video. So if you wanna learn, make sure to subscribe the channel to keep us motivated to bring more value and more videos in this channel. Okay guys, so without further ado, let's get into the screen where I'm gonna show you guys how you can add percentage discount badge on your collection and on your product page. So guys, this is the Horizon theme as you can see on my screen, and wherever I have added the compare price, you can see that it is showing the percentage discount badge hill, right? And for changing the color scheme, this is completely within the Shopify settings. So if you go to customize and navigate to badge, so in the customized settings, click on theme settings, and here you're gonna go to badges. Here you can change the color scheme of these badges. So if I change the color scheme to this one here, you can see that it's now white and black. You can also create new color scheme if you want to, if you know how to. I'm gonna create another tutorial for that. This is not the tutorial for creating color schemes, but for adding this discount badge on the collection. So this is for our collection. And now we're going to look at the product page. So let's go to the product page. On this product page, you can see that we have this badge showing up, which is an animated badge. And you can change the animation of this badge. You can change the sizing, colors, all from the product page template. So if I go to customize and navigate to the product page template, products, I only have one product template, so it is default product. So here we have this price ball block, which you can see product price WSP. This is not the default price block. The default price block is where it is, this one here. So that is the default price block. I have created a new price block which I'm going to show you how you can create. And that is the custom price block which I have created. And let me show you what are the features you will have on that. So we can change the alignment, but for changing the alignment, it is suggested to do it via the group alignment because it is in this group, which is the details part of the group. So make sure to change the alignment with this. So if I change the alignment from here, you will see that it's changing the alignment, right? Okay, so now let's go to the other options. Here we have the vertical spacing. So if I increase the vertical spacing, it is going to increase that. And let's try increasing the horizontal spacing. You can see that it added the distance in between for the horizontal spacing. Here we have the option to change the font size for the current price. So first we have the current price showing up. So if I increase the current price size, you can see that we can increase the current price size. We can change the color as well if we want to. Let's switch it back to black and switch it back to 24. Perfect. Now here we have the settings for the compare price. By the way, if you do not have the compare price showing up, you will have to add that compare price on the product backend. So if we go to the backend of this product, I'm going to also show you how you can add the compare pricing. So it will not show up even if you add the block and you don't have it on the pricing in the product backend. So first you will have to add the compare pricing. So for this product, which is all over printed polo, I'm gonna go to that product. And here, if I scroll down and click on any of the variant, you can see that I have added this compare price for this product and it is showing up on all of the variants. If I'll remove the compare pricing, this is not going to show. This is not going to show and this percentage is also not going to be visible. So make sure you have added the compare pricing, right? Okay, so here we have the option to change the color for compare price. Black, showing up as black now. Change it to red. See, it's now showing up as red, but the gray is most suitable here. And here again, we can change the font size if we want to. So you can change all of that stuff based on the styling of your theme. And now here we have the discount badge, which is this percentage. You can enable and disable that. And here you can add the custom text. So if you have your store on different languages, you can simply add in for that different language if you want to. And you can also add the dynamic field. If you want to have like a meta field value showing up here, you can also do that. And this is the value for the discount. So this 25 is coming from this discount and this is for the percent sign. Now if I change this to buy and save, you can see that it updated the text, right? But save is good for now. Perfect. You can also add just simply off 25%, or you can simply move it to the end, 25% off. Yep, looks much better. Again, we have the font sizing option. We can increase and decrease the font size. And here is for the font weight. It is currently bold. You can do that regular and medium and the semi bold. Here we have the text color, background color. Here we have some padding options and this border radius. So if you want to change the radius to be 19 or 0, you can do that as well. Now here is the fun part for the animation. Currently it is slide in and slide up. We have the option to add and bounce. And we also have the flash option, flash, right? We have the pulse and we have fade in and slide in up. You have already seen, we can change the animation duration here and we can also do this acceleration settings, ease in, ease out. And here we have the animation repetition. So if you just want it to be repeated only once, it's going to show the animation only for once, twice, three times, and this is for the infinite loop. I personally like the infinite loop forever one most. So animation delay, you can add in the delay in between the animation. So if I increase it to 10 seconds, 10 seconds, it's gonna be really long. So make it 3-4 seconds, right? Now 1, 2, 3, 4. There you go. You can see that we have the 4 second animation delay before the animation starts. And this is for the animation duration. So this is for the cycle. If you want to add the time in between each cycle, you can just increase that. Okay, now let's get into the implementation. I am going to install the fresh theme first so you guys can see. And again, it's going to work completely fine on all of the Horizon theme basis. So if I scroll down to the theme section, here we have Horizon, Saver, Vessel, I don't know how to pronounce that, whatever the theme is, it is going to work fine on that because these latest 10 themes which Shopify have added are all have the same Horizon base. So it's basically the same code. It's just a different styling, right? So let's add in the fresh Saver theme. Yeah, let's try on that one. I'm gonna install this fresh Saver theme to show you guys how it's gonna work. And while it's being installed, if you are new to Shopify, make sure to subscribe to this channel. And there's a link in the description. If you sign up through that link, you will get your Shopify store for just $1 a month. So make sure to use that link whenever creating your new Shopify store. Also, we have created a lot of tutorials for Dawn theme. If you're still using the Dawn theme, we have this transparent header for the Dawn theme. We have the mega menu tutorial, and we have this person discount badge, which I'm creating for the Horizon theme. And we have this a lot of different sections, which we have created, just like this pricing section as well. So for the sections, it's going to work completely fine on the new themes as well. But for the customization part, it's not going to work, because those customizations were for Dawn theme, not for the Horizon theme. Okay, our theme has been added. I am going to publish that. Click on publish again. And here we go. Our theme has been published. Yep, let's preview that. I'm going to close the old tabs which we don't need anymore. Let's close that one as well. Okay, so here is our Saber theme. Saber, right? Yeah, Saber theme. And as you can see, this is the default badge. Whenever you add the compare pricing, it's just gonna show sale, not the discount, whatever the discount you're giving. And that is the product page. You can see that it is just showing the compare price, not showing any discount badge, right? And our goal is to add that discount badge, which is gonna show the percentage discount. Okay, let's go to code editor, click on these three small dots, and then click on edit code. Okay guys, we are in our code editor, and this is the instruction which we need to follow. You will find the link of this article in the YouTube video description. You don't have to sign up for any newsletter. You don't have to pay anything. You just need to click on the link which is in the YouTube description and follow the instruction which I am teaching you guys. Okay guys, so first we're gonna go to product-car-badges file. So let's go to that. And here is the file, product-car-badges.liquid file. And here we will search for this code and replace this code with the following code. So I'm just gonna replace this code here with the following code. So let's replace that and scroll down. So that is our code, right? I am going to remove that code and then copy this code here and then paste the code. Perfect. Let's hit save. And now let's go to the collection. Let's click on the home page where we have collection showing up, and you can see that our percentage discount badge is showing up. Again, you can change the color scheme from the customized setting, just like I have shown you guys in the starting of the video. Perfect. Now let's add that on the product page. And for that, we're going to create a new block. So click on this blocks, click on add a new block. You can name it whatever you want. I am going to name it product price badge product price badge. Let's do that. So after creating the code block, make sure to remove all of the current code, go back to the article, scroll down, and here you can see we have this code. So click on copy code and paste all of the code. After pasting the code, hit save. And you are good to go. Now if I go to customize theme, and let's open up the product page template, products, default product, and here I am going to add the new price block. So here we have the price block showing up, which is the default price block. Let's hide that one, right, and add in the one which we created, which is going to show up on the top. And it is not showing up on the top, so let's search it. There we go. So you can see product price WSP. Search for WSP and you will find that. And once you add that and move it here, you can see that we have our person discount badge showing up. Ta-da! Okay, so we have all of the options just like we had on the one. Currently animations are disabled. You can enable that. Again, you can change all of the settings. All of that kind of stuff is still there. And it is going to completely work fine on the mobile version. You can see it doesn't really affect the mobile version. So that's it for the tutorial. I hope you guys like it. Let me know in the comments below. Until next video, hasta la vista, baby.